שלום.
שלום, שלום,
Hello everybody, my name is Ojas and I would like to do this lecture and workshop without this mic. I don't find it comfortable, so do you mind? I try to speak like this.
What I was saying at the beginning, I prefer not to use the mic. I prefer you to talk louder, but it's like if I ask, can you hear me in the end?
Recording, I think
we use the stand. So now what we're going to do today is for 1 hour now we try to understand this modula and the needs for this modula and learning should be at the 2021 in 7 years from now. And today we touch something very specific who have to do with the activity or the pedagogy, where pedagogy, and it can fit with any content. So it can fit with math, English, literature, geography, etc. Okay? So before we start, I want to show you, in any innovation, in any good idea, should start with a need. Okay? What is the need of this new idea? And when you know the need, then you can develop the good idea. So we start with three great needs. The first one is this theory developed by Alvin Toffler. It's a famous writer and philosopher. And Alvin Toffler in his book is describing the age that humanity is crossing. Okay? So as I said to the first group yesterday, you don't need to take photo of any. I will send you this PPT through the ORF and you can get it and enjoy it. So at the beginning, at the 18th century, we start to move from becoming hunters into becoming farmers. Okay? It doesn't mean it wasn't farmer before, but it means what is the most of the people have been doing. What was the most majority of jobs? So you start on the 18th century, agriculture age, and most people start to deal with agriculture. As we move to the 19th century, people are dealing with the industrial age, so more people are working in industry. And as we move to the 20th century, more people start to work in the information. Meaning information means all people who are dealing with insurance, financial, also education. Okay? So all the people who basically delivering information and dealing with information. And what we see now as we come to the 21st century, more and more people, let's see what it's saying.
The MOOC course that I took with my students recently was a very good opportunity to study differently, to learn differently, to teach differently. MOOC enables the teacher to use much broader resources, audio-visual resources, information references, much broader, much deeper than regular class. The specific class that took the astronomy MOOC course with me in the Australian university actually took advantage of part of the package, so to speak. We did learn in small groups, we did help each other. At certain opportunities, the students were teachers and the teacher became a student. But overall, this is not a revolution to be done overnight in one course. One of the things to be considered is the technical background. What helped us very much was a batch of laptop computers with a router that we could install in class when we needed it to enable small groups to work around the internet, view the videos, and this was very helpful. Since you did most of the studying at home, and at class we elaborated more about the subject to ensure that everybody understands what was learned. One of the things that we brought up when we summarized the course for ourselves was the possibility to study things that are within school curriculum. Specifically, the students pointed out history as a curricular subject to be studied in the MOOC way. I cannot tell at the moment whether this is a splendid idea or something that we will do in the very next year, but I think it is an opportunity to be taken, and I would love to go further into it.
Okay. So, as you see these principles, now I want to talk about actually what is your role in the team. Basically, you are the coach. And as the coacher, you have few missions. You need to build up the team, the relationship, the personal relationship between the kids. You must help the players to realize in what they are talents. Okay? You must balance between the stars of the team and the weak of the team. Okay? Why I'm saying that? Because many teachers, when I come to work with them, they tell me, yeah, but in my class, I have this and that. Students are very good. They are very wise. They're clever. They're good in all the subjects. They are very good. And I have some very weak students, and I don't know how they can be a teacher as well. Okay, this is important to see. Because what we need to give is confidence to these weak students. I tell you a secret. When you look at average number scores, what is actually can bring it up? It's the weak grade. If the weak grade become up, the whole average of it is. So it's important that everybody will be together. And many of the people that now are really successful people, when you ask them about school, they will confess that they've been a bad student, or they didn't go to school, or even names like Bill Gates, or other times then we didn't finish schools, okay? So if you have a weak student, doesn't mean he's not smart. Maybe you have other problems that are disturbing him in order to succeed, and we must help him to find his talent. And maybe his talent is just to be a good organizer, just to be a good friend and support the team. And sometimes also what we are doing, if we want to help them, we take like 2-3 less smart kids, and we teach them something, some subjects from the curriculum that the other student didn't learn yet. And then we let them teach it. Okay, in that way they feel more confident. Okay? And in that case, I want to tell you a story for the greater culture. It's a story in the Jewish tradition. It's about a rabbi. You know what is a rabbi? Rabbi is like a guru, okay? So, like a priest in the Christian, or like a guru in okay? So he is the one who is in charge of teaching the Bible stuff and the spiritual stuff, spiritual teacher. And 2,000 years was only learned spiritual stuff, and he wanted to teach them, the kids. But he didn't know how, because the kid was no schools, no organization, okay? And many, many children were all over the place. So what he did, he took 5 kids from the streets, and he teach them really, really good. And he tell them, now what you learned from me, each one of you will go and teach 5 kids. And after, ask them to teach another 5 kids, and another 5 kids. And in this way, you're able to teach the old village and the old villages around where he used to live. Okay? We call him Rabbi Chiye. It's a name, a very ancient name. And we say he's the inventor of the jigsaw. You know, jigsaw way of learning. Yeah? So he's the inventor. So the culture is also need to foster the operation in the team. Okay? So what tools that the coach got? You make an annual training program. You make it, you put it on the wall of your classroom. Okay? So everybody, all the players will know what is the plan of training. And we call one thing training and one thing a game. What is the game? What do you think is called the game on this graph? The exam, the test. Okay? So with the date of the exam, actually the date of the match of the game. Okay? And between the match, we are practicing, we are training. Okay? So let's say we have four big exams during the year. Okay? And between this, we are practicing. So we have one line of achievement and one line of time. Okay? So we start very low. We start because our achievement average is zero. And then as we keep going, maybe in the next game, we are already, let's say, here is 60. The score average, maybe, or even less, maybe we reach 10-20% more. And maybe in the other game, we will reach less. This is something that happens a lot. You cannot think that you're going to win all the time. But this is bringing us to learn from failures. Okay? Learning from failures is really, really important. Something that is happening a lot in the high-tech, in the startup. We only heard about the most successful exit, people exit for millions of dollars, the company, etc. But what we need to know is behind each success, there is at least 20 times that this startup or these people that built the startup fail. So when you fail, it's a place to grow. It's a place to jump from it. It's a place that you can use in order to increase the motivation for the next game. I'm telling it because schools are really bad with failure. It's almost not allowed to fail in school. It's really, really bad if you fail. Your parents get angry with you. Your friend thinks you are not smart. Okay? You get the fail on your test, and your inside the emotional, you feel a failure. And you're convinced because everybody around you, and you are just a child, everybody said you are a failure, you must be a failure. And this is influence to create a circle within your psychological effect. And we know the most important things for children to succeed is to actually experience what is a success. So you must give them the experience of success. How are they going to success? If you lead them through the strengths. If you know what is the strengths of this kid, you can give him a success experience. Okay? Let's say I have a student in my class, and I realize his strengths is really a fast runner. He can run fast. Or another student, she really knows how to cook special food. Okay? So I can also use these strengths in the classroom to give her the confidence that she can succeed. Okay? Doesn't have to be from the field of the curriculum. Okay, it can be from other fields, and then when they feel successful in this, they're able to success in other fields. So actually we keep going and then we feel a climb. Okay? And this we have more lines like in other subjects. So we have a line for math, or we have a line for English, or we have a line for literature. We can have many lines as we want, because our team knows to play different kind of games. And another thing that's really important, I have time, or it's, I don't know.
5.
I have 5 minutes? Okay, I take 5 minutes extra. So I just run with assessment. It's really, really important to evaluate yourself, how you progress, okay? Normally, the assessment in school is really, 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 I can say, lack of imagination. It's really simple, you get tested and you get tested, okay? Here, I want to give you a few other ways to assess. First of all, home test. You can give your student to test themselves at home. Okay? And also they will be the checker of the test. So they will come and say, I test myself and it was like this and this. Okay? You feel more comfortable. Then you tell them, open material. Okay? So they can, you can examine them with open material. Notebook open, books open, connect to the smartphone, whatever. What? This you do, I'm sure.
Open book test.
Open book test. And this you can be checking by the other peer. Okay? Another thing is the unlimited time. Okay, you can do a test, unlimited time, and this maybe the teacher will check, and maybe you can do, in the end, a real conditioning exam. And when you say expert, we mean the teacher for math will test this, and the teacher for English will test this, okay? Another thing you can do is a coach board. So you put what's going on this week, how is the training going to be, what happened this month, the schedule, what is the progress graph, as we saw before, the graphs, and what is the task. And another thing, you should do what we call the measure of the network. Once a week, you sit with your student, and you make like a summarize of this week. And you can ask them four questions, or maybe you will ask them different questions, and you ask them to answer on the graph from 1 to 10. Okay? Normally what we ask them is, did they learn from other kids this week? Did they teach other kids this week? What is my obligation for the group goal, for the team goal? And how do I feel in the team? Okay? And then everybody answer in numbers, and you make an average, and you know, okay, our measurement for this week is 5 on this, this and this. And when everybody reflect, make a reflection and everybody can see it, then we start to ask them what will help us to improve, what we should do next week in order to feel better, to feel more obligated. And you don't believe that the kids will have the greater idea. Okay, they will give you the ideas. You don't need to think about the answer. They know the answers. Okay? Here I want to show you one more movie. It's about no time. 5 minutes. Okay? 5 minutes. And then we finish. So this movie, actually, it's a... You're gonna see also kids talking about their experience in the team, and teachers and principals. We took it in one city that we work a lot in, Netanya, and they talk Hebrew, and you have subtitles in English, and so you have the chance also to hear Hebrew, which is a funny language sometimes. The name of the school is Nordo. Okay.
בית ספר נורדו מונה 400 תלמידים, שליש מהם יוצאי העדה האתיופית, שליש יוצאי חברה עמים. יש לנו צוות מסור שנרתם כדי לקדם את הישגי הלימודים. אנחנו שנים רבות מנסים להעלות הישגים, אנחנו עולים, אבל גודל ההשקעה לא מניב את התוצאות המצופות. חשבנו מתוך התסכול הרב שלנו, של הצוות, לנסות משהו אחר, משהו שעוד לא עשינו עד כה.
ואז עלה הרעיון של הנבחרת. בעצם כל הסיפור זה ללמוד אחרת. כשתלמידים מלמדים תלמידים אחרים, זו המתודה שבאמצעותה הם לומדים הכי טוב. וזה בדיוק מה שאנחנו עושים כאן בבית ספר. אנחנו בעצם יוצרים כיתה שיש בה 38 מורים. כל הכיתה הופכת להיות גוף אחד עכשיו, שצריך לדאוג אחד לשני.
הבנו בכיתה אתם רוצים מטרה משותפת. הילדים הגיעו למטרה, הם רוצים העלאת הישגים בשפה. הם הציגו לעצמם רף של 85, לממוצע. שאלתי מי רוצה להיות מורה, מי חושב שהוא צריך לקבל עזרה. אמרנו שאנחנו יוצאים לדרך. הילדים מתחלקים לקבוצות, לכל מורה יש את התלמידים הקבועים שלו, יש קלסר שבו הוא מתעד את מה שקורה. כל מורה מעדכן את התלמידים שלו, פונה אליהם, אומר במה התקדמת, מה ההערכה שלי כלפיך ומה צריך לחזק בהמשך. אני נשארת בכיתה עם המורים, עם המינימורים, שכל אחד מדווח על התלמידים שלו, מה הם עשו בקבוצה ומה עליהם לחזק בהמשך.
הפיילוט של הנבחרות בעיניי זה משהו מאוד מוצלח, אותי זה שווה והקסים מלכתחילה, וכרגע אני עובדת עם קבוצה, זאת אומרת כמובן יש לי את ההקנאה לכולם, אבל אחר כך אני לוקחת איזה קבוצה של טובים, של כאלה שאני סומכת עליהם, מלמדת אותם את ההקנאה של השיעור ככה הכי טוב שאני יכולה, הם קולטים את זה מהר מאוד ומתחילים לפזר את זה בכל הכיתה, כי הם הבינו שבשביל להעלות את הממוצע הם צריכים גם להקפיד על לקרוא וגם להקפיד על להכין שיעורי בית ואת כל התחנות בדרך עד כביכול המשחק שאנחנו קוראים, כדי אימון, 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 משחק.
אחד מהעקרונות של נבחרת בעצם זה הוא לתת תפקיד לכל אחד בכיתה, ובכיתה חינוך מיוחד זה יכול מאוד לעזור ולהרים, כי יש שם מגוון רב של תלמידים שבאמת לכל אחד יש את הייחודיות ואת התחום שהוא טוב בו. אני בחרתי לבנות איזושהי נבחרת חברתית. יש בכיתה כמה כוחות מאוד מאוד חזקים חברתית. לקחנו אותם כראשי קבוצה ויצרנו סביבם מעגל חברתי של קבוצות שפחות, של ילדים שפחות מסתברים ביניהם ופחות מוצאים את עצמם חברתית. בעצם המטרה שלהם זה לשמור תמיד על איזון חברתי, על כבוד הדדי, ותוך כדי זה אני רואה ממש בפועל שהם מתחילים ליצור ביניהם איזה שהם קשרים שככה מעצמם לא היו נוצרים.
אם היו אומרים לי שכיתה הזו תעבוד בצורה עצמאית כאשר בראשה של כל קבוצה יש מיני מורה שמוביל ובודק ולוקח מלוא אחריות על הלמידה, לא הייתי מאמינה. פשוט טענו, כשאני מסתכלת על הכיתה שלי ואני עוברת כמו פטפט בין קבוצה לקבוצה ונהנית מזה שילדים מסבירים מושגים אמנם במילים שלהם וכל כך שואפים להגיע גבוה.
יש לנו נבחרת במקצועות שפה, אנגלית, מדעים, מתמטיקה וגיאוגרפיה.
הצוות החינוכי משתף את התלמידים בקבלת החלטות.
אני ממש בעד לשתף את הילדים ולתת לזה לצמוח מהם.
נותנים לנו להעביר רעיונות לאיך אנחנו יכולים לקדם את עצמנו.
יש לי השפעה על התלמידים שהולכים לבית ספר.
יש לי אחראית מסוימת על תלמידים, אני צריך לדעת שהם ישאפו לתוצאות טובות ושהם ישפרו את מה שהם עושים עכשיו וידעו ללמוד נכון.
אני מין מורה במתמטיקה, אבל בשפה אני תלמיד.
לפעמים אני עוזרת לה והיא עוזרת לי.
אני לא מתביישת לקבל
שם. אני אחראית מה יהיה בתעודה שלהם. ואני אחראית מה יהיה במבחנים שלהם.
אני צריכה להוות דוגמה לתלמידים שלי.
אני מיני מורה בחשבון, ואני מבין שאם אני אבוא בלי שיעורי בית, או בלי קריאת ספר או החתמה, אני לא ארוץ אחי אלא לכולם.
בועז, אם אני מלמדת, הוא מעדיף לוותר, להרים ידיים, להתעסק בעניינים שלו. אבל ברגע שישראל מצטרף לתמונה, התמונה נראית לגמרי אחרת.
נח לי ללמוד עם ישראל בגלל שבגיל שלי.
החברות שלנו התחזקה מאז שאני עוזר לו.
פשוט כיף ללמוד ביחד איתו.
לא רק שהוא מיני מורה, הוא גם חבר.
אני מרגישה שהאווירה מאוד השתנתה.
אני מרגישה שעכשיו התלמידים קיבלו יותר ביטחון.
הכיתה עכשיו יותר שקטה, יש עכשיו יותר רצון ללמוד.
התלמידים מרגישים יותר שייכות הכיתה
אני יכולה להגיד בפה מלא שרמת האלימות ירדה בכיתה.
אני מרגיש שיש מישהו שעוזרת איתך, שיש חיה כאילו שדוחפת אותך קדימה. היא רוצה שתעלה את ההישגים שלך, ואם אתה לא מצליח, אז היא לא אומרת לך, היא לא מבטלת עליך, היא ממשיכה, וממשיכה עד שאתה מצליח.
אני יכול גם ללמוד מהתלמידים שלי.
ללמד עוזר לי יותר לחזור על החומר, וזה גם, אני יותר חושבת ומרגישה שגם זה עוזר לי, אני משפיעה גם על עצמי. גם יכולה להעלות את ההישגים שלי.
זה שאני מבין מורה, נותן לי יותר ביטחון.
אני מרגישה כאילו יותר מכובדת.
אני מרגיש בתור מורה כיף שיש ילדים שפונים אליי ומבקשים ממני עזרה, אז אני מרגיש עליי חיות וסיפוק.
אני לא חשבתי שאני אשאף להגיע למקומות כאלה. עכשיו אני מורה.
החלום שלי זה שכל התלמידים שלנו יהפכו להיות מורים ושהם יהיו משמעותיים אחד לשני, שבבית ספר שלנו לא יהיו 30 אנשי צוות אלא שיהיו 400 אנשי צוות, שכל תלמיד הוא יהיה גם מורה. אני בטוחה שאחרי שנגיע לכך שכולם יהיו מעורבים, גם ההישגים שלנו יעלו ובאמת באמת נוכל להגיע כל היעדים שהצבנו לעצמנו.
All right. So just two things, I hope you got it. They call the teachers children mini teachers. And as you see, it doesn't have to be that in math class everybody will be a teacher. Some kids will be teachers in math, other will be in history, other will be in English class, other will be in sport class, other will be in agriculture class. Okay? As soon as you feel teacher in some field, it's enough who is confident. Another good important thing they say, sometimes for kids easier to learn from another kids. They speak the same level, okay? You feel more sometimes when the teacher sit with him, he's shy to say I didn't get it. Or he's shy to make mistakes or not okay involved much. But when he sit with another kids, it's more easy sometimes. And also they have kids language. Okay, so this is really, really important. So we take a break. You want
to
ask?
I'd like to share my experience with all my teacher friends. Actually, I teach English in my class, but I do enjoy sports also. So every year, in the month of December, we have a sports competition related to Surya Namaskar. Group activity, we have Anna Samstha, Maharishi Kadra Srikshan Samstha, and many branches all over Maharashtra. So, so what I did, experience the success, so your team, your this motto, that helped me a lot. I think last 10 years, I've been working out with this special thing. I choose 6 to 10 students from my class. Our class has been nearly 80 girls in my class. So I take 10 to 15 students, I myself demonstrate them how to do Surya Namaskar. And these 10 students take a group of 5 girls, and these 5 girls, again, they rectify each one. Ki mere paas sab barabar hai, is it correct? My position, my breathing system is correct or not? And the teacher and those 5 girls, they have been come to me. The teacher just watched, they are doing it correctly or not. And after this, already 80, when I just take them to the hall, ask that I just go to each group and just observe that how are they performing the Surya Namaskar, how are they demonstrating. And from that, from these students, I choose my 15 best competitors for the competition. But there is, this is very good that every day in the morning, 160 students perform Surya Namaskar for 5 minutes. They do it all the Tera Mantra, and this performance. 160, 144, 34 standard and 45 standard. And these have been trying out last 10 years.
Wow.
So, and featuring my cap, the last 7 years, we have been attaining the pros general championship for students.
So it's come back
130?
210. 230?
210.
10 past 2.
Let's see. So this activity, it has to do with the first principle of the team, which everyone in the team is a teacher and a learner, and we want to try it. So it has a few stage, and just follow my order and it will be great. The first stage, each one of you will look within himself and try to see something that is unique, his talent, okay? And also that he wants and can to teach it to the others in 10 minutes, okay? It can be anything from any field, doesn't have to be from education. It can be from your hobbies, it can be from any world, okay? Arts, music, dance, food, whatever you want. Something that you are very good at, something that you know and hold it, and you can and want to teach it to the others in 10 minutes. When you find these things that you want to teach other, you write it down on the paper that you got, on a big, like a title, and you put it on your chair. The next stage, after everybody finished to write down, you walk around in your circle, and you see what other people wrote down. what is their talent, skills, what they are planning to teach. If you find something which is interesting you, that you want to learn it, you write down below. You write your name below the title, okay? When you see something which is already three names below the title, the list is closed. You cannot check in. Okay? So after three names below the title, it's closed. Okay? This is the first two stages, and after we go to teach it and learn it. So everybody understand the first activity? Or you need it to transcend? Maybe someone will say it in Marathi? Everybody understand? Really? Okay, let's go for it. Start. Look within yourself. Try to think about... You understand? You need someone... You need repetition in Marathi? Yes? Maybe you say Marathi?
Ane.
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 Ane. Can you repeat in Marathi?
No. Don't repeat in English.
Pratyek group madhya एका कोणतरी आपल्या बाकीच्या ग्रुपमधल्या सहकाऱ्यांना आपल्याला जे काही चांगली गोष्ट येते ती 10 मिनिटाच्या शिकवायची आहे.
Each one for on his paper write something.
One activity.
So now, the groups should be not more than four. One teacher and three students. Okay? We take now 10 minutes, and you choose the one you want to learn from, and you go and you start the learning. Okay?
Thank you. काबू करण्याने किंवा रिंग पद्धतीने दुसऱ्याला पकडण्याचा प्रयत्न करतो.
Para mañana. सीनियर है सगळ्यात पहिले त्याच्यानंतर तुम्ही हे बोलत काही पण पण सुरुवात म्हणजे माझ्या ट्रेनिंगची सुरुवात असतं
कधी कधी आपल्या
So you cannot read all
of them? No. Cannot read.
No.
No. No. I can only read two and three. One is Hindi, Sanskrit, and maybe one or two, like which is more like Gujarati, maybe, like, but not more than three.
You seen, is it a problem or a national
level? Sir, Marathi is also different.
Also in Marathi?
In Maharashtra, no, but, is no, in the state. You see, no, no languages are different than each other. Unlike in English or Hindu, like the characters are
is this word reflexia reflection everybody so, you know reflection okay so now we do reflection of what we have here okay so each one in his turn will say how was it for him to learn and if he was a teacher also how was it for him to teach Okay? And maybe he also finds something new about himself so he can tell. This we make first circle, first round. After, we make another round and you think what things you can take from here to your classroom. How you can apply this, what we did here today, can be about the principles of the team or activities. How you can apply it, some ideas, how can I do it in my class? Okay? You need it in Marathi? You need it in Marathi? Okay. So we take 15 minutes. It's your stage. Okay. Everybody was we must finish now because we want to go together again before we end the seminar. So, one moment. Is anybody have a question? Good. I want to say one last thing. One last thing, first of all, it was a really pleasure for me to work with you, and it was just an interpretation, the beginning of this process, and I hope I will have the chance to come more to India and to Maharashtra and to keep working. Even though it's just 2 hours of open minds to see different things of innovation in education, I believe that some of you will take it to the classes and will try to do something with it. If it's happening, please write me a mail and tell me that you are doing it, and then I will be the most happy man in the world. Okay? Really. And I can also give advice maybe through the mail. For some people who want have a questions, okay? So in that way we want to create communities. Like in Israel we have more than 300-400 teachers that they are from different places and different cities and different schools, but they have a group on the Facebook, and when they come into the difficulties or they have new ideas they want to share, so we create community of teachers around the world that they can get advice from other teachers or give new ideas and to say, look, we tried this team in our class and we succeed to do this and this, okay? In this way, we encourage our colleagues, because remember, we are not anymore in competition with each other. It's finished. This is the old world. The new world is open code, open knowledge. Knowledge is for everyone, everywhere. So if you don't share your knowledge, you don't receive. You must share, you must give. This is the movement, okay? You must create a movement within yourself to pass and receive, okay? You cannot say, okay, this is me, this is what I know, I'll be in my classroom, this is end. Now we have one global village, okay? The old world, one global village. You can take a idea from a teacher in the United States or from Australia or from Japan, and they can take ideas from you, okay? This is great. There is one more thing. I don't know when you will have computers in your classroom or if you have computers that connecting to the website or to the internet. You may use with one great tools. I didn't have possible to show it because it's no connection to the internet here, but this is called Connected Classroom. So you go inside it. It's a Google site, and there is many, many, many activities for students that they can see in videos, other classes, the way they learn, and to learn together with them. For example, maybe one class in Africa, they're going to learn about elephants, and they will take a tour to see elephants or giraffe. But you cannot fly now with all your student to Africa, but you can do this through the internet, okay? And this is only one example, and there is many, many source of knowledge. So I want to end, because we are in a time of changes. So there is a great sentence, which I think Mahatma Gandhi was once said, be the change you want to do. Be the change you want to change, okay? You must feel it and be. You must behave like this in order to influence your student. Okay? So thank you very much. Namaskar.